It's lovely to see it again. Welcome back. Thanks for coming back on. Congratulations on the tour.
Thank you. I'm so excited. I've never, you know, toured in the UK before, so it's very exciting.
Well, I've just come back from Madrid, and you'll be pleased to hear your poster. He's laughing because it's... I'll tell you something, Hillary. Take your umbrella when you go to Madrid.
Is it raining?
It snowed. It hailstoned.
In Madrid?
In Madrid. But I think that's my fault, because while I was away, it was a beautiful,
weather.
Sunny day. And I came back, and it's raining again.
Oh, no, yeah, that's awful. Yeah.
So it's my fault.
I was just there, and it was, like, sunshine and beautiful, and yeah. So it must have been your bad luck.
That's me, Kent. That's me. But your posters are everywhere. They've really done a huge poster campaign for
you. That's good to hear.
Yeah, so you're all over. So it's hola to Madrid. Now, the new single came out last week.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we've got a clip of it here. Now, Bear, please, if you would. Your new film is inspired by Madonna.
Well, you know what? Her company, Maverick, produced it.
Yeah.
So it is called Material Girl, which it's not really anything about her, though. You know, yeah. It's about me and my sister playing the movie. And
Oh, your sister's in it as well?
Yes, yeah. We are, which was a lot of fun.
Yeah. Is there any rivalry between you and your sister on
no.
the set?
No. You know what? She's my best friend. Like, I live with her, and we get along really well. And on set, it was cool because, you know, I travel so much, and she works so much that we don't get to spend as much time together anymore. So, like, we drove to work every single morning together, and we shared a trailer, and it was fun.
And does she sing as well?
She does. She sings, and we're actually going to cover Madonna's song, Material Girl.
And you know, this is a first, because Madonna's never allowed anybody to cover one of her songs.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, she's obviously a big fan, Madonna. She's like... Who do you play in the movie?
My name's Tansy, and we play these really wealthy sisters, and it's quite funny. They kind of, it's like a riches to rags type thing, and then they build themselves up, and it's very cute.
Okay. Now, we've had loads and loads of emails from your fans, so I've got some here now. This is from Sarah in Brighton, and it says, was Steve Martin a good dad?
He was. You know what? It was very hectic on set because there was like 12 kids. But he's great. I loved working with him.
Yeah.
And it's funny because he's just such a normal guy in real life. And then when it's time to like be funny and he just turns it right on, you know. And some days on set, if they were not such busy days, he would like bring the banjo. He's been playing the banjo for like 12 years. So that was cool to have him play like an instrument on set.
So he can play the banjo?
Yeah.
We have to get him on, Bert. And we've got one from Lauren in Sudbury. Is there going to be another Lizzie McGuire movie?
I don't think so. You know, I haven't filmed any Lizzie McGuire for like 4 years. So they rerun it so everybody thinks that it's still on, but we haven't done it in a long time.
I told you, last time I got addicted to Lizzie McGuire. See that? And I was pretending it was me godson that was enjoying it, wasn't
it?
It was me.
I used to watch it with my little brother.
Well, it was you who was mad on, isn't it? And we said, oh, my godson loves Lizzie. He did. It was me. I was mad on Lizzie McGuire.
I remember that. You told me that.
Yeah. Now that... we've got, did you fancy Superman?
Superman? Do you know what they're talking about?
No.
Well, in Cheaper by the Dozen, Tom Welling, who is on the show Smallville, his show, I think, is, do you know the show Smallville?
Yeah, we played your brother.
Okay, yeah, he played my older brother.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't think he knew, but I do think he's very cute.
Oh, did you have a bit of a crush? Well, he knows
he's
now.
Married, though, but he's just really, he's really a nice guy and he's really funny.
And we've got one from Liz in Exeter. Is your stuff on sale here? That's the clothesline, I know that.
Right. Yeah. We just actually relaunched the clothesline. It'll be out, the new line will be out in the States in about a month. So I think the accessories line will be at Claire's here sooner, and then the clothing line comes out more in the fall.
Where do you find the time to do clothes? I mean, it's
amazing,
isn't it?
Yeah,
it's just amazing.
Oh.
You know, all this wonderful career you've got.
I'm so lucky, right? You know what, I think that just having a good team around me and keeping people that know how to stay organized because I don't, you know, and they keep me on schedule and I don't stress out because they do. And I don't know, it's fun. I'm young and I have energy and I get to have all these, like, exciting creative jobs, so.
Do you eat properly and all that? And do you exercise and,
I do, yeah.
Yeah.
I've tried actually on this tour to be better about like going to the gym, and because you know when you exercise you feel good about yourself.
Yeah.
But I have the biggest sweet tooth in the world.
Oh, snap.
Like I wake up craving dessert. I'm like, I want dessert. But
have you got a sweet tooth, Jake?
No, I'm more of a savoury person.
Oh, are you more, more savoury?
Yeah. Might be pies.
Yeah. I like sour things. That doesn't surprise anybody, does it? And we've got one last one for you from Max in Hall Green. Have you got Eminem's album?
Oh,
oh, you know why? Because Eminem says he likes your derriere, doesn't he? He makes sense.
What?
Your derriere. Your posterior.
That is so funny. I'm going to bring that expression back to America.
What, derriere?
Can I steal it?
Yeah, of course you can. Your derriere. It's a bit of French, that,
isn't
it? You
took it from the French, you can tell
Yes, exactly. Exactly. And lastly, now, I don't understand this one. You've had problems with a goat.
You know what?
No, I totally sympathise because I've got three goats.
You don't have goats?
I do, seriously. I've
for
got,
what?
For three goats. I've had them for eight.
Your house pet?
No, I've got a small
how
farm.
How does your dog get on with them?
He ignores them, totally. Buster ignores
He ignores everyone.
He ignores everyone. That's the Greta Garbo of the cat. But I've got goats. Seriously, I've got three goats.
Really?
And one of them's very, very tricky. I have to watch myself with him.
Like little pygmies?
But they were supposed to be pygmies.
Oh, and they overgrew.
Overgrew? They're bigger than me, Hillary. They're huge. Did it bite you, this thing? Or...
No, you know what? It's actually, it wasn't a problem with the goat, but a long time ago, I was filming this movie, and it was like a straight-to-video movie called Casper Meets Wendy. Really embarrassing.
I remember that.
You do? Oh, gosh.
No. It's another one I pretended to watch with my godson, and I loved it.
Well, I had to wear this little red, like, Wendy the Witch suit, and there was a scene where I was, like, chasing after the goat. And I don't know how a goat got in the movie, but it was very random. But the director kept yelling, the goat's name was Meaner, and I didn't know that. And the director kept, and I was supposed to be in a bad mood chasing after this goat. And so the director kept going, Meaner, Meaner, Meaner. And I was like, trying to look at my face. I was only like 11, you know, it was like the first movie I ever filmed. So each time he'd be like, cut, cut, let's go again. And each time I'd be like huffing and puffing and like grinding my face up. And like, he's like, Hillary, are you angry? Are you upset? What's going on? I was like, you keep yelling at me to be meaner. And he's like, the goat's name is Meaner. And I was so embarrassed. I was like, oh my gosh.
I like that movie. I liked Wendy's sisters, three aunties. No, they were aunties, weren't they?
Yeah.
Three right meanies, they were.
Right.
Yeah.
They were great actors. It was Kathy Moriarty.
Yeah, I love Kathy Moriarty.
Terry Garr and Shelley Duvall. So.
Yeah, yeah. No, that was a great film, that. Seriously.
Thank you.
But I like all the kids' films. Do you?
Yeah, I like all films.
And me. But especially children's films, cartoons. I still cry when Snow White dies and the dwarfs around.
Snow White's great.
Oh,
scary
fabulous.
As hell, though.
It is the queen.
Have you noticed how there's always like a mean woman character in those Disney films?
They're always mean, aren't they?
Yeah.
The villainesses. I wondered, is he a bit of a misogynist, Disney? Because it's really, because it's... But they're always beautiful.
Yeah,
like the queen
You'd make a great evil queen.
Me?
Yeah.
Thank you, James. I have been accused of that in the past, but it's vicious life. Hillary, it's lovely to see you again.
Thank
it really
so
is. Good luck with the tour.
Okay.
Yeah. Good luck with everything, in fact. And good luck with the single.
Thank
Ladies and gentlemen, Hillary Duff. Come on, let's see you.